School, this beautiful time, kisses, flowers, chocolate candies, friends, and that is so bullshit in Bulworth. Only force works here right. Either you'll kick asses or your ass would be kicked. Let's say Buddy is the younger, less famous brother of GTA, well, the third part at that point. The game was published by Rockstar Games and developed by their Vancouver studio, and I think I'd finish with boring facts right now, so you can read it yourself in somewhere like Wikipedia. The action takes place in school. Our protagonist, Jimmy Hopkins, is sent over to a new school, Bulworth. Well, not really a school, but an academy. And even not a just an academy, but an academy boarding school, due to our sneaky friend is the fifth wheel in his family at the moment. So, in order to get rid of a dearest son, his ma and her new boyfriend, who's not a boy anymore for sure, decided to leave Jimmy in this beautiful place for a year, while they would enjoy themselves on the cruise. Alright. I don't want to spoil much and rob an opportunity to explore the story yourself, so I'd finish with the story here, but just to provide you a bit more background and to explain what's going on there. Everyone around you is completely nuts. The society in school is divided by groups. There is of course main antagonist and also five factions in the game, like nerds, preps and other shit. Well, in reality, I would say there are four factions, plus so-called bulls, anarchists, something like that. Anyways, faction-wise, we cannot join any of them, though actively participate in their lives and meet more closely one by one through the story. By the way, I won't say that the world is enormously huge, no, but running around won't do any good either, so to make it faster you can use skateboard or bikes, and by the way, latest might be purchased or built modified during shop classes. And last thing is the bus, which might be used to get to the school quickly from any of the bus stations in the world. Also, there are loads of minigames in the game. So, any class, for instance, is actually a minigame. These might be divided into those which develop one of the distinctive features of primates, well, if controller used, and just in case, I'm speaking about thumbs, right? And others, where you have to think a bit. There are two lessons during the day, and it is sensible to visit and complete them. Why? First of all, if you like all the different gear, you might get some after successfully completing classes or new abilities like excuses. Well, my personal favorite would be ability to kiss, like to raise morale, self-affirmation, and well, to get some bonus to HP as well. There are several arcade machines in the game, so you can perform actually kind of a double play. As I said before, the action takes place in school, and our hero is a schoolboy, so, as you my dear nerd might already figure out, there are no guns like pistols and stuff like that, but there are other interesting tools available for sadists like petards, sting bombs, some flugigeheimen and slingshot. By the way, these flugigeheimen shots with small kind of rockets, and when I saw it first time was like, Jesus Christ, that's cool, that's gonna be cool, and no, that's shite actually. So all this stuff is available to produce in your own cam lab, in your room, and the assortment expands if you successfully finish the cam classes. Alright, the game is cool, I believe you won't regret time spent on it, quite a funny story, interesting world, long story short, I would suggest trying it, play, don't blame, and see you next time! We'll be right back.